Patching is made very simple in the LZX specification thanks to the standard input-output jack labeling scheme. Filled circles are outputs, and outline circles are inputs. Before patching, you should tune your instrument by setting the switches and dials on your modules to their default states. The user reference card for each module details the proper settings to start with. Now turn the system on and verify output. You should be able to patch any LZX specification signal generator, such as the ramps from the visual cortex or wave outputs from the prismatic ray, to an RGB input leading to the decoder, and see your output on your display. Don't be discouraged if you don't get an output immediately, as some of the settings we discussed here, or unique settings specific to your module, may need to be addressed before the output will appear, especially if you didn't reset the device to its default settings. When patching inputs and outputs within the system, the only cables you'll need are 3.5 tip sleeve male-to-male connectors with cable lengths less than 2 meters. Some users might be familiar with these connectors as mono audio connectors for portable consumer electronics. Stacking cables can also be used to connect one output to multiple inputs. Every output has the power to deliver signal information to up to 4 input jacks simultaneously with a loss of signal of no more than 5%, or an equivalent loss in bandwidth. When combining multiple outputs to a single input, however, hardware mixers should be used to protect the circuits. Within the LZX specification, all inputs are tolerant of voltages up to plus or minus 12 volts, and output voltages never exceed plus or minus 12 volts. Getting external video in and out of the LZX specification is accomplished with composite and/or component RCA female connectors, necessitating the use of RCA male-to-male connectors for most displays and external video connections. Labeling of RCA video inputs and outputs follows the same standard as the 3.5 jacks. Filled circles are outputs, and empty circles are inputs. The visual cortex additionally sports an S-video output, and the upcoming Memory Palace and TBC2 modules even have DVI analog connections. Within the LZX specification, video output from the system follows established protocols, so no matter how you patch or add input data to your device, the output will always be a valid, displayable video signal. These steps include black-white level clipping, sync insertion, amplitude control, etc. For more technical details and discussion, please follow the link in the video's description, the LZX Patchable Video Standard on the LZX Community Knowledge Base. If you're still having trouble getting your video synthesis equipment to work, we'd be happy to help get you up and running. Either comment here on this video or visit the LZX Community Knowledge Base for help troubleshooting. And most importantly, have fun patching.